Hey guys, Spencer Kaufman here with How To Video Channel. Today we are going to show you how to build a retaining wall using decorative cinder blocks. So here we've got cinder blocks, they're decorative. We're going to be building a retaining wall with it. It's going to be a decorative wall. The blocks are not going to be used with mortar. We're going to glue them together to have a tight bond, and we are going to be putting the wall right here. So it's going to go just like this, right along this corner, and then right down the other corner. So the first step you're going to want to do is make sure you have all your materials. Obviously, you see here we've got this side is prepared already. This side is not. We did that to show you the difference. You're going to need some gravel, crushed granite if you'd like, and of course the blocks, your different tools such as a level and adhesive to secure the blocks together, a caulk gun, etc. So the first thing to do is to prepare the grade. So you can see here, this is really rough. There's still grass and unlevel soil, different things like that. So it is unprepared. It's not ready for the block to be put on it. In order to prepare the grade, you need to get some good crushed granite or gravel, something like that, that you can work with, move around easily. Make sure it's very well packed, so you're probably going to want to use a tamper. You can either use a hand tamp, or you can rent a compactor, or if you have one, great. So what you need to do next is make sure it's level. So I've gone through and leveled this already, using a long level, 6 foot level here. Now you can see right there, we're dead on. Just slide it down to another section, and right there, we're good. So you can proceed doing this all the way down, and you'll see that it's level. Now the reason this is so important is because if your grade isn't level and prepared, you're not going to be able to lay up the block as fast or as good. So right here you can see we're a little bit off. No big deal. That means that this end is high. So we just take this down and make sure that underneath we're touching all the way along so that we know it is good and level. So you can see this is prepared. What we're going to do now is prepare the other side and then come back and show you what it looks like when it's all ready, and we'll start laying some block. Okay, so here we are. We have the other side prepped. This side's all level, as you saw earlier. And now we've got the second side prepped out. The grade is prepped, it's leveled. We leveled it with the level just like we did on the other side. And then the next thing to do is take a tamper. Now this is a hand tamper, so when you push it down, you really want to pick it up high and then push it down hard so it drops hard, and do that all the way down all along each end. And then when you're done with that, you'll be ready to lay your first block. So we're going to tamp it, then come back and start laying block down at the corner. Now with this one thing to notice is that even though the blocks are 8 inches wide, which is about like this, I went out even more than that for two reasons. One, it's always good to have extra room. Two, this particular wall, because we have a fire ring on the inside and then we're going to have landscaping and yard on the outside, we are going to have decorative block on both edges. Now the client wanted a wall that's double wide so that this could serve as a seat for the fire ring. That means that we've got 8 and 8. So we're gonna go out 16 inches with block. So it'll be two rows. So the first row is gonna come overlapping and then like this. And then the second one will come outside that and over. So in this case, we leveled out and prepared the grade for a little more than two block wide so we can lay two rows of block. So we're going to tamp it and then come back and start laying the block. All right, here we are. We are ready to lay the first block. We have everything all tamped, and we are going to start at this corner, and here's our block. So the decorative edge is right here, which would be on the inside. What we do is take it and we're going to set it down here. And you can see that already it looks to be slanted. So we'll check it, and it's way slanted. So it's not level, but this direction, it's pretty close. So we've got a few different levels here. You want the 2 footer to check couple blocks, and then a 6-footer to check multiple blocks. And a short one like this really helps for a cross in either direction. So right now we are definitely higher in the concrete side. So we're gonna take this and we can either scrape this down or we can move some over here. Now, since we've tamped it, anything you add here, you don't really need to re-tamp it again. Just make sure it's kind of packed well, and then we can try again. So we'll make sure we're nice and snug up to the edge. Make sure we're good there. And here we're a lot better. And here we're a little off. So you just keep trying that process till you get a couple blocks laid. We're gonna lay them down so they're nice and level all the way along the edge of the line. So we can do this a little bit more. We'll get one block set. This is where some leveling sand or some gravel, if you want to use that, can really help. Also helps if you've got some extra hands helping you out. So here we are. We're pretty level. Now, if you're using mortar, you can keep it. That's about a 16th off. That's just fine. And then you can just tap down your mortar. Or here, we'll just kind of pack down that side. Again, we want to make sure right there. See, we're touching, we're snug, but we got a little gap. That's okay. We can't get it all touching or we wouldn't be straight. Now we'll check this way. Looks like we're a little off. We need to be higher here, just like that. So it's a process, but once you get that first block laid, you can continue on the rest of the line. So here we go. We're going to lay out the first course both directions on the first wall, then we'll come back and do the second wall, which would be a decorative block like this out on the outside. All right, so we will do that and come back and show you what the first course looks like before we lay the second wall first course. So we're making some good progress here on the wall. We've got several blocks put in. And as you can see, if we slide the level back, we've got it level there. And as we move it forward, still level. And all the way up, still level. And then this little one is handy on each block. So the one we just set, it's level that way. And level that way. And one thing to note is that with this type of wall, with the textured blocks, you can see we've got a gap there because the edge of the concrete isn't perfectly smooth because the concrete went over the top of the form there. And also these are not going to be perfectly smooth. You can see the second one here is a little bit thicker on the edge than like the first one. So that one's touching, whereas that one's not. And that's just the nature of the beast of this type of job here. What you can do is take your level and put it on the back. Now this isn't gonna be level because these aren't exactly the same, but you can make sure that your level is touching all the way across the block. So you can see here that we are. And if we're not, and we're really close, like for example here, we're about a 16th of an inch from touching. So what we could do is just kind of bring this out a tad like that, and now we're touching. Then the other thing to note is that with this type of wall, it's only going to be 3 courses high. You're definitely going to want to fill the cores of at least the bottom 2 with some type of sand or gravel, just to help with stability of the wall so it doesn't tip. Obviously, you're going to have a running bond here, a stacked bond, one where your block overlap each other. So when you have that type of a bond, it will help with the integrity of the wall, but still filling the cores will also help a lot. So we're going to continue building, and we will come back and show you the next steps. Okay, so here we are. We have the first course done of the first wall all the way along. Here the first side, here the second side. We had to cut a couple blocks to make them fit, one half and one just snip the end off. And as you can see, we have the level going back and forth, and we're just about on right there. and then you level this way. And then of course we went through, and you can go like this with the end one and make sure that all of these again are touching the level, just to make sure that your wall is straight. Now this is going to be the inside of another layer, so it's not as important, but it still is important when it helps to set the second wall first course. So here we go. Now the next thing we are going to do before we lay the outer wall is fill all of these cells with gravel, so that when we're putting the course down for the second part of the wall, we don't move them or dislevel them or get them off in any way. So we're going to fill them with gravel now. Okay, so here we are. We're filling the cores with some nice loose gravel. So it's pretty simple. Take a shovel full of gravel and then dump it right in. Careful not to mess anything up, hitting the brick too hard or the block too hard. And dump it in, then you can smooth it out. Now, you don't really have to compact this, because as time happens, it'll settle and we're not a huge wall. Now, if you were filling these cells with concrete, then you would want to put a vibrator down there to make sure that you had that compact and solid. So here we go, we're gonna fill that up and then start out on the second wall's first course. All right, so the first course of the second wall is coming along nicely. Now this is a little more tricky, because you need to make sure not only to level the blocks each direction here and here, but you also need to level the blocks next to each other and then across the long way like this. Make sure that's good and level. And then it really helps to go across blocks like that, or like this, in as many different directions as you can, as long as you're crossing the points on the block that make for level. And then of course use the big long 6-foot level to make sure you're still level that way. Now, some of you may be saying, why did you line up each wall with itself rather than doing it like this, like a running bond? Well, because we're gonna do a running bond on top so that they will be held together. Each wall will be a running bond of itself, and then the walls together this direction would be a stacked bond, so to speak, because they line up with block to block. Now, we could have staggered them, but due to the fact that we're only going 3 high and that these are going to be very hard to tip over anyway, we don't need to do that in terms of that bond. And the ends look nicer. Plus, we're going to put a cap on them, and the cap is exactly the size of 2 block together like this. So we'll be able to just lay them on. And what we might possibly do on the top is start out with a half and then do fulls, so that we're continuing our running bond with the capstone block. So here we go. We are going to continue laying this first course of the second wall all the way around, and then we'll come back and show you the finished product once we have filled the cores with gravel. Okay, here we are. We have the first course of both walls completed and filled with gravel. So now comes the tough part of making sure the second course goes on well and that it is a running bond, which means that each block overlaps between middle of block to middle of block so that they tie it together. Now, one thing that I find important to mention is right here. So this is a corner and there is a flat spot here. You can see typically you would want to purchase a corner block. So these are split face blocks because they have the exposed aggregate, or they're rough on the edge. Now, they do make a corner block that has the rough on both sides. However, in this case, they were out. The only time or way to get them was to special order, and the people who want this wall built did not want to wait for that, so they wanted to build it as is. So when the wall's done, you're gonna have a plain one here, there'll be a plain one here, and another plain one on the third course that you will see. But sometimes that's the way it goes. So here we go, we've got that all filled in, and now we are going to build the second course overlapping, and make sure when you're building the second course, you use a good adhesive to secure each layer together. We've got some right here. Sorry about the wind. We have Loctite PL500 landscape construction adhesive. So we're gonna put a good amount of that on each of the top blocks before we lay any of the second course. So we'll come back to that and show you that process. Okay, so here we are. We have the adhesive applied. So it's very, very simple. Just a matter of squeezing it on and then putting it wherever you need it. One thing to note is you're going to want more adhesive in the middle, because you know that if it squishes out, it's not going to come outside of the wall where you can see it. Like here, if you put a lot and it oozed out on the edges, you'd have to clean all that up. So put more on the inside and just a little bead on the outside. Then take your block and simply set it on and make sure everything lines up well. Now, it's important to note that until it dries, it's not set in stone. So you can see here, we're pretty good right there. Now, if you go around to the corner, you can see there, we're lined up. As I mentioned, normally you'd have a corner block, but in this particular case, they were out of stock and they just want the wall built. So here we go, make sure it's good and solid, and then continue on building right down the row. Every few blocks, you'll again want to check for levelness, but since you've leveled the bottom course, continuing courses should continue to be level at the same rate as this. So if you're off on the bottom, you're going to be off on the top. So that's why it's so important to make sure your bottom course is completely level. So I'm going to set a few blocks, then we'll come back and take a look and see the progress. Okay, so here we are. We have the second course on both the first and second walls completed. So now the next step is going to be to fill this second course with gravel and then prepare for the third course. So that's that. We'll fill this with gravel, come back and show you what it looks like. Here we are, we have all three courses up of both walls. So the next step is to put on the capstone, which will be the ledge that they will sit on. So that's going to be a lot easier. It's a 16 by 16 square that will sit right on top of these blocks to make a nice bench seat. So as you can see, we've got everything core filled and we are ready to go. We'll use the same steps, apply the adhesive, and then lay the block on. So we'll show you laying a few block next. We've began laying the top capstone course. So with this, it is very important that you put a lot of adhesive on the insides for sure, because if people are going to be sitting on this as a bench, you don't want them going anywhere. So as you can see, we've got the good beads, we've got a couple laid. We're going to continue lay the rest of these on and then come back and show you the final result. Here we are, the job is finished. So we have put the capstone on all of the wall and it is now a nice bench. So there you have it. That is how to build a retaining wall bench with decorative landscaping block. As you can see, the capstones laid on there very nicely and it is at a good height for a bench. So it'll go well with the fire pit, the pergola there. The next step would be to put some good landscaping, maybe some bullet blocks or some edging, some nice flowers around the exterior of the wall to completely finish it off. But there you have it. That is how to build a retaining wall or landscape wall decorative bench. So if you like this tutorial, please click that like button. Also hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to be notified of future videos. Thank you.